Good morning, YouTubers. This is Staten Island Prepper here. One thing that a lot of the videos don't show, and I don't know whether it's because they is how to heat your home in an emergency. Now, being in an urban environment, I don't have a fireplace. I don't have a wood stove. And when my power went out for over 72 hours, it was rather cold. But I did have these portable heaters by Coleman, and the middle one is by Century. Now, I just want to go through each heater with you, okay? These are safe to use in the home. These, you have to have a window open no matter what kind of heat you're going to use. So let's start out with this first one. This is a radiant heater. This heats objects. So if you're cold, you want it in front of you, pointing towards you. And the heat that it gives off will heat the surrounding areas eventually. But it's basically designed, any radiant heater is designed to heat an object. Now, one of the things that you want to remember, never have your face above here. And from here up, it gets very hot. Because the heat will radiate up and out this way. This is an adjustable one. You can actually pull it out and push it in. And that will direct the heat for a wider or narrower path towards an object, which obviously would be you. And just so you know, I do have a fire extinguisher off camera, although my wife does want the kitchen done. So let's light up this one so you can actually see. Now on the top, it does say high, low, light. So we're going to kind of turn this little puppy around. And you hold it down until it starts to glow. Then you release it. Alright. Now this will throw out I believe it's 3,500 to 5,000. This is on the 5,000 BTU setting. And if I turn the little dial, this is on the 3,500 setting. Now, most of the time, you probably will want to keep it on the 5,000 setting because the 3,500 is a bit anemic for anything but the smallest rooms and smallest areas. I heated a 10 by, oh, I don't know, 15 foot area with this, and it worked quite well. It kept us comfortable in a very dark and dismal situation. If you ever want to find out if you're prepped and you're ready to go, well, here's something you can try. Go down to the basement, turn off the main breaker, and live without electricity 24 hours, if you can. If you have an electric stove, it's even more of a challenge. I was lucky enough, I have a gas stove. Plus, I had my camping gear, which I could have taken outside and cooked on, so that I was prepared in that aspect. But if you really want to see if you're prepared, turn off the main breaker. See how long you could go with the main breaker off. And then that will not only show you how long you could comfortably survive, it'll show you what you're missing. And probably that's one of the benefits of that test, to know what you're missing. Not what you have, but will it work? And always, always, always test anything you buy new. Never keep it in the wrapper saying, oh, I'm not going to unwrap it until I need it, because you don't know if it works. You know, it's kind of like a toaster. You know, one day you put your bread in, push down the button, toast pops up. Next day you put your bread in, push down the button, nothing. Why? Who knows? But it's the same idea with testing out your equipment. Always test out what you have. All right, I'm going to turn this little puppy off now, and we're going to go to the next. This gets really hot up here. I mean, like, third degree burn hot. So be really careful not to touch this whole area. All right? Okay, the next one is another Radian heater, and it is smaller in its heating capacity. I think it's rated for about 3,200 maximum BTUs. So now I'm going to turn this one on. The valve's in the back. Now you did see a little pop-up of the flare. Alright, this is high. Now what it's going to do is this area in here is going to heat up. Again, this is a Radiant type heater. Now, above here, gets extremely hot. So you want to have at least 36 to 48 inches clear above it, not near any curtains. If you have little ones, this may not be the best option for you. Okay, or pets, this may not be the best option for you. All right, so now this is kind of going full blast. And again, it puts out a significant amount of heat for a home. Make sure, if you do any of these options, that it's on a non-flammable surface and there are non-flammable things above and to either side of them. You don't want this falling down on your carpet. Okay, it could get ugly. It does make a little bit of noise. By the way, these propane canisters last anywhere between, you know, I want to say 4 to 8 hours. On low, you probably get about maybe 6 hours out of it. I've gotten as much as 8. Don't ask me what the deviation was, why, I don't know. Now we're going to go to our next heater.
Turn the puppy off.
Great. Our next heater is a Coleman ProCat heater. Now this is a little different than the other two. The other two are Radiant heaters that heat objects, and then eventually, because of the heat they give off above them, and this is still really hot, they'll heat the air in the room. All right, so you kind of want them pointing at you. This is a convection heater. Now, this will heat the air. This will heat the air in the room, and it also is powered by 2 D-cell batteries, which aren't in there at this time because I don't keep the batteries in a appliance. They might leak. So let's fire up this. Again, there's a knob on the back, which I really like. Now, there's a knob on the back, a little catalytic heater. This is 3,000 BTUs. This, again, is a convection heater. It will heat the air. All right. So now let's just turn this little puppy on. Once you get that little pop and flare, it's on. Then you let go. The reason I'm doing this now is at the end of winter, usually everybody wants to clear out their garages and attics, and you might be able to get some real good buys. Prices are going to vary, you know, and shipping's always a bear. No matter how cheaply you get it, shipping's going to be significant. All right, YouTubers, thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing to my channel. Please rate this and, you know, subscribe. I'd like to hear your comments, both positive and negative. And this is a family channel, so I would really appreciate you know, watching your language and what you say, okay? All right, everybody, have a great day. When tragedy strikes, it never gives a warning. So prepare now. God bless. And your shoes get so hot, you wish your tired feet were fireproof. With my